Hello, precious family, YouTube family. I hope you all are doing well. The Lord is asking for true repentance. He's really hurting for the world and the disasters that are to come for the sins committed in this nation and around the world. He's been very clear about repentance and this nation turning from the evil ways of Satan and embracing righteousness, peace, and love. The enemies of our souls do not spare us any time. They are always putting bad thoughts into our minds and hearts, enticing us to anger, pride, lust, greed, covetousness, and all sorts of abominations. Dear ones, America is in great danger because of the sins they have allowed within this country. Sins such as abortion, homosexuality, pornography, child sex trafficking, satanic abuse of children, satanic offerings of innocence, sorcery, blasphemy, sodomy, masturbation, etc. I can go on and on and on. These crimes against humanity call out to the divine justice of God, and He must judge these crimes against humanity. He must judge sin, beloved ones. The Lord hates sin. Our Savior suffered the most cruel and humiliating death to make atonement for our sins and satisfy the divine justice that is owed to us because of our wicked deeds. Yet this is not His heart. His heart is mercy. The Lord does not rejoice in the death of the wicked. He desires that the wicked turn from His way and live, even as He says according to the book of Ezekiel, end quote. But if a wicked man turns away from all his sins which he has committed and keeps all my statutes, does what is lawful and right, he shall surely live. He shall not die. None of the transgressions which he has committed shall be remembered against him. For the righteousness that he has done, he shall live. Have I any pleasure in the death of the wicked, says the Lord God, and not rather that he should turn from his way and live? That's Ezekiel 18:21. I kept getting readings about iniquity and evil and repentance. I thought it was for me, and honestly, it started to scare me. I struggle constantly with scrupulosity, and I'm constantly looking over my shoulder to see if I'm doing okay with God. Satan has a part to play in this too, since he is constantly condemning me in my mind and putting fear in my heart. It's really hard, guys, I'll be honest with you. But God's grace is sufficient for us. Today, even in the readings for Holy Mass, we got readings about Jonah being sent by God to warn Nineveh, and how they turned from their evil ways and repented. The second reading was from St. Paul to the Corinthians, telling them that the time is short and how the world is passing away. And of course, the gospel was Jesus telling Israel to amend their lives, repent, and believe in the gospel. I believe this is the Lord's way of telling us that true repentance is the only thing that'll save us. Beloved family, the world is passing away, along with all its riches and pleasures. The only thing that matters is the salvation of your eternal souls. The Lord is returning soon, and His reward is with Him. He will repay every man according to his deeds. Do you know what the biggest torment for the damned souls in hell? They wish they would have listened. Their conscience torments them more than anything in hell. They are reminded of all the opportunities the Lord sent their way to warn them of danger that lies ahead on the path they were traveling, all the pastors and prophets he sent to them, their friends, YouTube videos, letters, accidents, trials, radio stations, all that he did to try and get their attention, yet they wouldn't listen to him. They hardened their hearts and persisted in their own way. Is this how you want to be? Is this your goal in life? To gain the whole world and lose your own soul? Please, beloved ones, I beg you sincerely, heed the voice of the Lord God. The road is wide, and the way is easy, I mean terribly easy, that leads to destruction. And many people go there. But the road is narrow, and the way is hard that leads to life, and few people find it. Lord Jesus, at this point I ask the Lord if He had anything to say to you guys, to us as His children. And Jesus began speaking. Thank you for asking. Indeed, I do. My children, I've tried many times to get your attention and warn you of the path you are taking, but you resist me. I've sent many of my servants to you to inform, teach, and convict your hearts, but still you put me off and ignore me, thinking, these are just made-up myths. There's no way that's true. May I say it is true? More true than you will ever know? Oh, how I wish to spare you of all the coming danger in this world and in the next. But I need your repentance, dear ones. I want you to amend your lives and follow me. Turn away from the crimes you've committed and do what is lawful and right. I will be faithful. I shall forgive your sins and remember your iniquities no more. For I love you and created you for the purpose of love and joy in me. Yet as you continue to sin, you are digging a hole right into hell, and I cannot save you on the day of judgment. My justice demands payment for the sins committed against me. Some of you are not prepared to meet me after death, and you know it. However, you are still delaying your conversion. I say to you, the time is short. You are not even promised another hour upon this earth. I can call you at any moment. So please, my children, my creatures, my beloved souls, whom I've created out of sheer love, please listen to the call of your God. Please, I'm asking you in tears. I died a horrible death to deliver you from the consequences of your sins. I love you. I want you in heaven with me. Do you hear the voice of merciful love? Listen to your heart, for I am indeed knocking. It is not my wish that you perish, but that you be saved and live. And for those of you who serve Satan, do you really think he cares about you? Do you really believe he has a kingdom prepared for you after death? I can answer that for you. He does not. He has you to lie, steal, kill, and destroy, because he does these very same things. If he has taught you to lie and deceive, do you really think he will be honest and truthful with you? There's no truth in him, for he has been a liar from the beginning. He's duped you into thinking I'm bad, and he is good. He is a master deceiver. My children, I still love you, even though you may hate me, and have been fooled by him into thinking I am to blame for all of the evil that has happened in your life. He came at just the right moment in your vulnerability and offered you pleasures beyond your understanding. If only you promised him your allegiance and worship, teaching you to steal, kill, and destroy others like himself. All the while he's laughing you to scorn, because once you die, he will then mock you and humiliate you as you claim to await this promised kingdom. He will laugh you to scorn and tell you how much you were a fool to believe him, sending his demons to torment you and throw you in the fire, laughing at your screams of agony and torment. And the greater your devotion was to him on earth, the more scorn you'll receive as a result. At this point, I can do nothing for you. I am helpless to save you, since you chose your master. I will never betray you, for I love you tenderly. I will heal all of your pain and wipe away every tear from your eyes. My banner over you is love. I desire you with me in my heavenly kingdom. Satan has no kingdom prepared for you, beloved. Only the fires and divine wrath that I've prepared for him. I have now set before you, my children, life and death, good and evil. Choose life and good, for the time of judgment upon this world is approaching. Amend your lives before it's too late. Don't let me be forced to say to you on that day, I never knew you. Depart from me.